singing. The sword of Damocles is swinging. And if I hear your cell phone ringing, I'll kill you myself. The whole big dead thing. Death can get a person stressed.
We should have parted way from the end. Now we're never gonna see him.
I can show you what comes next, so don't be freaked. Stay in your seat. And yes, I sing like this 8 times a week. So just relax, you'll be fine. Drink your $50 wine and take a breath.
Welcome to a show about death.
Everybody gets on fire here, like Roger's Hart and Hammerstein here. The women's bathroom has no line here, just be where you want. The whole big dead thing, nobody gets
clean. I
worked
out, I am clean.
Jesus passed the trim of me. Time to face the brutal truth. Cause we're all on a hit list, might not live till Christmas. Joke the devil just gets paid, that's just statistics. So take a little break here, it's kinda like a wake here. The scenery is fake here, but there's a giant snake here. Hi, Sandy! It's dinner time, come on. We're all hungry, so come on, come.
Welcome to the show about death!
You're hanging on me, fine. On the other side, are you good?
I'm not good, but down deep in my
profile.
Hey, I'll be your guide to the other side. Seriously though, this is a show about
death. It's taboo, but it's always something new. There's something radical, professional to do. To maybe just kill you.
If you die during this performance, we're gonna keep going. Screen Showcase 2023!
Has the curtain gone up yet?
No.
Has the curtain come down yet?
No.
Oh God. Will they love it?
Will they hate it?
Ugh, the nerves are killing me.
I know, I feel like I'm going into labor!
Well everyone, Meg!
Meg! And I just want to wish everybody good luck.
What did you say?
That's her tongue!
What? No, I said good luck.
Oh, I said it again!
Now has anybody ever told you? It's bad luck to say good luck on opening night. If you do, I tell you, it is certain by the curtain you are through.
What?
It's bad luck to say good luck on opening night. Once it's said, you are dead. You will get the worst of you if you've ever read.
Good luck.
Even at the common friends say, on opening nights they're scared. Boy, Chan, mess with me, no one says. The only word you ever hear is
MERD! Good luck, good luck, good luck.
Take your shield up on opening night. Take advice, don't think twice. Or the show will surely end up in a shite. At the famous Scarlet Moon. They say with love, and just for luck, they all shout, Bahaloo!
I got it!
Now I'll never say good luck on opening night. That's the rule, I'm no fool. What do I say, I beg?
What you say is break a leg.
Break a leg?
Yes, break a leg. If you're clever,
pizza. At the top, you guys just came up for practice and you're hungry. Mom, just do some dessert at the top. Everyone ready? Let's go for a take. Little Caesar's Pizza, take one.
Action.
Hey, great practice.
Yeah, it really works up an appetite.
Me too, I sure use a snack.
Little Caesar's Pizza,
they're the best.
And now we have 20% more real cheese.
That's awesome!
Plus, they're way better than what she usually makes.
Hey! I am your mother!
Cut. Cut. Cut me light. No, like, hey, I'm your mother. Say boy.
Oh, no, I definitely got it. My mistake. Right back.
Try it again. Little Caesar's Pizza, take two.
Action.
Hey, great practice.
Yeah, it really worked up an appetite.
Me too, I sure use a snack.
Little Caesar's Pizza, they're the best.
And now we have 20% more real cheese.
That's awesome!
Plus, they're way better than what she usually makes.
Hey! I am your mother!
Aren't we cutting?
Yeah, what's happening?
I'm coming out. Like, hey, I'm your mother.
Yeah, like, hey, I'm your mother.
Should be really easy.
No, I think I know what I'm doing wrong here. I think I know what the problem is. What was the word you used to
play? Playful.
Got it. Gotcha.
She's never going to get it, ma'am.
You should just fire her.
No, let's just let her do it over and over again until she gets it. It's a stupid idea. Little Caesar's Pizza, take 3 through 8. And action.
I am your mother! I gave birth to you! I'm your dad and I'm poor and he's not been child support!
Great team today, guys.
Meg, back!
What happened? She fell through the ice.
She was skating by the bridge. The ice gave way right beneath her. I got here just in time.
She's careless. She's rash.
I was skating so beautifully.
You don't think. You know you're not supposed to skate by the ridge. Everyone knows the ice by the ridge is dangerous.
But you didn't want me skating near you. I love your story, Joe. I tried to write one to make up for what I did, but I couldn't think of anything to say. So I drew that picture of you with your beautiful hair.
And my big mouth.
And she ignored it.
You skated recklessly. If that hadn't been for Lori, you could have been killed.
Maybe better if I had.
You must never talk like that. When the ice broke underneath you, all I could think of was how I could have lost you.
Then go on, Joe. Forgive her.
See how much she's changed.
Everybody stop it. I was devastated when you burned my story. I couldn't understand how you could do such a thing.
Promise me. Promise you'll never think of me as an enemy, but as a sister who loves you.
I promise, Joe.
Mark, sisters forever.
Forever.
Forever. Sorry.
Lori, you saved Amy and made this day possible. I want to declare before everyone, before the world, that on this day of forgiveness and joy, that you, Theodore Lawrence III, who has valiantly lost all contests to me, I declare you our brother, the brother we never had. Swear to us your greatest oath of loyalty, an oath as dazzling as your charms.
I swear I'll follow you like royalty.
I'm wearing royal coat of arms. Proclaim on me our joint, and we shall not be parted. From this day on, it's all for one, and one for all for life.
But live like musketeers.
Together we'll prevail. We'll be fine for all forever. Our bond will never be undone.
Nothing shall sever this fraternity.
We'll always live and die as one.
From now on we are joined, and we shall not be parted. From this day on we
will fight for all for life. Together we will fight.
On this wonder,
it's wonderful.
One I'll never forget.
Never forget.
I am.
I am.
be our brother too.
Makes it luck.
We'll consider any friend.
We won't deal to the end.
We'll be fine for all forever.
We'll be fine for all forever.
We'll be fine for all forever. Don't now on and on and on. From now on.
Army of troglodytes charge into the cave, their tails banging against the ground. Boom, 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 boom.
Troglodytes. Told ya.
But wait. It came from the Demogorgon!
Yeah!
We're dead. I told ya!
Will, your action!
I don't know.
Fireball!
I have to roll 13 or higher.
Too risky. Cast protection. Fireball.
The Demogorgon is tired of your silly bickering and takes a step towards you. Boom!
Protection. Fireball
protection. He takes another step. Boom!
Don't be a weak fireball!
Protection!
Hero! Oh, come on, Mom! 15 more minutes!
It's school night, Michael. I just sent Holly to bed. You could finish this next weekend.
But that would ruin the energy, Mom!
Michael!
I'm serious, Mom. It's about 2 whole weekends to plan. How was I supposed to know it'd take 10 hours?
You've been playing for 10 hours?!
Well, we have to wait for the pizza.
Okay, let me just be clear on this. I haven't heard from you in a week, and now you want a mathematical equation that you should know so you can save the world?
Susie Poo, I promise I'll make it up to you as soon as possible.
You can make it up to me now, but I want to hear it.
Not right now.
Yes now, Dusty Bun.
Susie Poo, this is urgent.
Yes, yes, you're saving the world. I heard you the first time. But Jed is also saving Earthsea and is about to confront the Shadow. So this is Susie signing off.
Wait! Wait! Okay. Okay.
Turn around. Look at what you see.
Make believe I'm everywhere.
626-7004.
You just saved the world. Gosh, I miss you, Dusty Bun. I miss you more, Stizzy Poo. I miss you more multiplied by all the stars in our galaxy. I miss you more than... Okay, but I gotta go. Bye. You, me.
So you could be wearing a Prada skirt and I could be looking like the dog in the model's bag.
Look at his sweater. Adorable.
That is a cute sweater, but he's not wearing pants. My mom will not be cool with that. I don't care about the pair as long as we go to school together.
So sweet, yet so. Not true. You picked out her first day of high school clothes in the fifth grade.
Fourth. Roller skates and Furby t-shirts. We may want an update. Are you worried that Dr. won't see you from school?
Nope, I plan on you to do that for the both of us.
I'm serious.
He'll clear me. I'm starting school this Monday with everyone else, and I don't want anyone at school to know I've been sick. Then they start treating me out weird and stuff.
I don't want anyone at school to know either. You already get most of the attention.
Especially Gwen Thompson. Can you imagine if she knew I've been sick?
Yeah, you guys might start being nice to each other.
Exactly! It would be horrible! 4 years of the battle against my biggest enemy down the drain. There he is. Oh, I keep volunteering. Push the call. Where is it? He's getting away. There. When he asks me if I need anything, I'm going to say your lips on mine.
You are not.
Watch me.
Hi. Can I help you?
A glass of water would be nice.
Like the one right next to you.
Oh, hey! Look at that! No, I meant to ask if you knew the time.
I don't, but we could check the clock against the wall.
Oh, right. I have cancer.
Cool.
Murdered.
Hogwarts. Little do they know the danger that's looking right under their noses. What should I say? On the back of their heads. I can't breathe in this turban, yo!
Oh, sorry, sir!
Same proportion. For if they knew that you lived when Harry Potter destroyed you,
yes.
Just something dumb.
Yes, my body was destroyed. I was forced to live in the forbidden forest, eat bugs, mushrooms, and unicorn blood.
That's where I found you. And then you attached yourself to my soul.
Yes, nobody must know about that. Now, Quirrell, get me some water. Now, Quirrell, pour it into my mouth. We must not have any more fights like tonight in the Great Hall.
Yes, my Dark King.
Okay, okay. Just relax with the Dark King thing, okay? I watch you wipe your butt. Daily. You can call me Voldemort. We are there. We have reached that point.
Yes, my Voldemort.
Now, Quirrell, get us ready for bed. We must be well rested if we wish to kill Potter. Tonight in the Great Hall, he was so close. I could have touched him. Revenge is at my fingertips, Quirrell. I can taste it. It tastes like cool mint.
That's a Listerine, Voldemort.
Yes, well, excellent. Now, Quirrell, get us ready for bed. Okay, I can't do this. We got it all over.
I can't sleep on my tummy.
You roll over right now, or I'll eat your pillow. You'll be having a dream, you're eating a marshmallow, and you'll wake up and your favorite goose pillow will be missing.
Fine. We'll compromise. We'll sleep on our side.
Okay, I guess I can do this. Now, good night, Quirrell.
Good night.
You won't sleep on your tummy. You won't sleep on your back. We're quite a goofy couple, you'll agree. We share some hands and fingers, and yet the feeling lingers. We're just about as different as anyone can be. You like plotting a garden, and I like plotting to kill. You think that you should rule the world, I think books are a thrill. Sipping tea by the fire swell, pushing people in is fun as well. I like folding all my ties, and you have no friends, and that's a surprise. I guess it's plain to see, when you look at you and me, we're different, different as can be. You're a sissy, a twit, a girl, I'm the darkest of lords.
I'm the brightest professor here, I've won several awards.
My new world is about to unfold,
you got beat by a 2-year-old.
I'll kill him this time through and through.
I just gave him another tattoo.
We must agree, when you look at you and me, we're different, different as can. I'll rise again, and I'll rule the world. But you must help me renew. For when our plan succeeds,
prevails,
part of that world goes to you. When I rule the world, I'll have snakes
and Jane Austen
giants, essentials, a fleet of dementors, and all my Death Eaters. When I rule the since I got that new shipment of exploding bubblegum, business downstairs is booming. How am I too funny, honeys?
Oh, Wilbur, you're the funny one.
Hey, I want to sneak a dance on a TV show.
You're going to have to go a lot further than that, young lady, to get around me. No one in this house is auditioning for anything. And what have I said about that hair? All ratted up like some teenage Jezebel.
Mother, you're so 50s. Even our first lady, Jackie B. Kennedy, rats her hair.
Well, you're no first lady. She's a hair popper. In fact, that's the same reason why you got sent to detention today, again. Wilbur, talk to Tracy. Girls like Tracy, people like us, you get what I'm saying, don't you? They don't put girls like Tracy on TV except to be laughed at. Just talk to her. Tracy, is this really a thing you want?
It's my dream, Daddy.
Then you go for it! This is America, babe! You gotta think big to be big. Well, being big is not the issue here. You follow your dream, baby. I'm heading down to the Hardy Har Hut and grabbing an orange crush. I got my dream, and I love it. You're not helping. Hold on, young lady. Come back here and help me with this laundry basket of clothes. My diet pill's wearing off.
But, Mother, all I was doing was watching the Courtney Collins show of our Tracy's.
Didn't I forbid you from listening to that race music? Oh, if the police ever locate your father, he'll punish you good.
Your dancing was atrocious today, Amber. I'm willing to lie, cheat, and steal to win you that Miss Hairspray crown. But you've got to work with me. Now let me out that zit.
Don't contradict me!
Don't disobey me!
Don't even think about going to that audition!
Please! No!
No!
Mother! Stop!
Stop!
Stop telling me what to do!
Don't
treat me like a child of two!
No!
I know that you want what's best!
Please!
But Mother, please!
Barely walk and talk so much as dance and sing.
than 23 pages of rules of the road, and not once do they admit that turning left into oncoming traffic is insane.
240 pages of werewolves and spaceships, and the only thing I've really retained is that I think I can tote fractures in Ecto Suit.
Stick with it till they get to the Lake of Mirth. He meets Kytra and the adventure really kicks off.
Hold up, cooperate, and listen. You've read this book?
Oh, yeah, I've read them all. They're great. And I've gotta say, I'm a little on the fence of you playing Tristan myself.
Okay, one, how dare you? Two, help me!
Why are you wigging out?
Because I really want this part, and trying not to look all bad, but it's like 10 times bigger than my show.
And it can put me in a whole new acting stratosphere.
I just have no idea how I'm gonna impress these fanboys.
I'd love to help you, but I have my driving test and I have no idea how to make a left turn. I just had a twin
Shane idea.
I'm twin intrigued.
This Saturday, I'll be you and you'll be me.
You mean?
As it's ready!
Here you go.
Thank you.
Here.
Thank you.
I'll face your fanboys.
And I'll take your driving test. Perfect! Why is this bed so squishy? Maddie? Because I'm sitting on a pizza.
A girl gets hungry.
Okay, we can switch lives, but we cannot switch beds.
What one?
Lights! Whoa, lights! Thank you. What did I start dancing? I don't know. I guess from watching all those movie musicals, I used to dance around the streets. I was always being Sid Charisse. Somebody told me they're looking for male dancing for the jukebox with you. You know, the drag show. I was finally in show business. It wasn't the drugs or the show businesses, but I was working. 4 shows a day. They decided to take the show to Chicago and my parents wanted to say goodbye. And they were giving my luggage to the theater after the show. I was going on for the finale and who should I see standing by the stage door? My parents. They got there too early. I freaked. I didn't know what to do. I thought to myself, I'll walk quickly past them like all the others and they'll never recognize me. So I took a deep breath. And I started walking down the stairs. And just as I passed my mother, I hear her say, "Oh my God." Well, I died. After the show, I went back downstairs, and there they were. And all they had to say to me was, "Please write, eat, sleep, and take care of yourself." And just before they left, my father turned to the producer and said, "Take care of my son." That was the first time he had ever called me that. My son.
I could be there to see. there, but... This dress needs to seal the deal, make a grown man kneel, but it can't come right out and say bride. Can't look like I'm desperate or like I'm waiting for it. I gotta leave one of his pride, so bride is more implied.
There she is!
Oh my god, you guys. All this week I've had butterflies. Every time he looks at me, it's totally proposalized. Oh my god, you guys! So help me dress for my fairy tale. Can't wear something I bought on sale.
Love is like forever, this is no time to accessorize.
Oh my god, you guys!
Well, I want to make my shorts so easy.
Excuse me, have you seen this? It just came in, and it's perfect for a blonde.
Right, with a half-loop stitch on China silk?
Uh-huh.
And the thing is, you can't use a half-loop stitch on China silk. It'll pucker. And you didn't just get this in because I saw it in last May's Vogue.
Oh my god, you guys.
I am not about to buy last year's dress at this year's price.
Help, stop, right, through that some girl's lies.
May be perfect for blonde, but I'm not that blonde. I may be in love, but I'm not stupid. Lady, I've got eyes.
OMG, no good, sorry, poor mistake. Courtney, take your break. Just ignore her, she hasn't been well. Try this lace from Milan, go on, try it on. I take care of my best clientele. It's a gift from me to Elle.
Exactly who you are. Come on, let's go.
Be very hard on the system.
Strychnine?
They pumped it out of me after you tried to kill me. I thought you'd come back and try to gather up the evidence.
But Violet didn't mean to. It was an accident.
So you admit you tried to murder me?
Mr. Hart, please, you don't understand.
Now, don't worry, you can make it up to me. Why don't you come to my house tonight?
How late do you want me to work?
Now, who said anything about work?
You are disgusting!
Guess I'm gonna have to call the police.
Mr. Hart, please, you ruin our lives! You put your neck under your ear, sorry.
Oh.
Alright, I can do this.
God, now untie me so we can work things out.
No. I can't do that.
I give you my word. I won't leave here until I work things out with you three.
Mr. Hart, I'd like to offer my sincerest apologies. You know, I really didn't really mean it. This is all just one big misunderstanding. What? You gave me your word!
I lied! My God, you are as crazy as the other two.
Jeremy, what are you doing?
I am taking care of business.
Well, congratulations, but now what are we going to do?
I say we knock him out and we leave town.
Here's an idea. I say we let bygones be bygones.
Don't listen to him. He lies. He lies. He lies. You sit there and be quiet while we think.
I know one thing. We've got to get him out of this office.
I'd take him home, but I don't think Dwayne would go for that.
Mrs. Hart's on vacation. We could take him back to his house.
Good idea.
No matter how long you keep me here, the second you let me loose, I'm turning you all into the police. So you've got two options. You let me loose, or you kill me.
Well, it's not a bad idea. I'm okay.
Wait, girls. Ladies. I mean, ladies. I do not deserve to be treated like this.
They say we always get what we deserve, whether good, bad, or indifferent.
That's what I always heard. No good deed goes unpunished, but the bad deeds you have done, stretched out, I'm sure that they would reach from here to kingdom come.
We think it's time you get what you deserve. You've got no true compassion, but you've really got some nerve.
And you've hurt every one of us
in different kinds of ways.
What goes around comes around, and each dog has its day. Under his hair is a brain that then you'd ever care. And you only see bits, but get this, there's a heart under there. Heart that you broke and then ripped out more times than a few. Woo! Well, all I will need, Dorley's gonna stick it to you. Woo! I'm gonna shine like the sun and he's clever away from my door. And when it's all said and done, I won't be at your mercy no more.
Before I'll get through it. You've hurt and embarrassed me, proving you don't give a damn. I'm tired of men like you who make me feel less than I am. I'm gonna shine like the sun as he's clapped away from my door. What's mine? Cause I know there is always tomorrow. There are no guarantees, life is always a hit or a miss. But I truly believe I won't always be feeling like this. Woo! I'm gonna shut up the sun when these clouds roll away from my door. Woo! I will crawl, I can run, I will be at your mercy no more. When we sing it loud, be so proud that we finally won. And when the losing's all done, we're gonna
so fill all spaces.